this oak tree and his customer's yard blew over. And this is a good point, because if you go over and stand at the tree where it came out, where the root ball came up, yeah, it's a good 50 feet from the lines. But since it's such a tall tree, we could spend, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars trimming this whole line, because these 33,000 volt lines are the most important lines we have. They feed our substations.
Wow.
And we spend a lot of money and a lot of time trimming them. All it takes is one big monster tree like that to get blown over and just smash everything. So even though the tree, the base of the tree was far from...
Yeah, it's not right next to the line.
And we get a lot of this. So it's...
So when you have to trim trees, you have to go further back. It's not just the ones near the line,
well,
if you can.
Yeah, so you can imagine with customers, you know, this... Yeah. I talked to this gentleman.
Okay.
Because, you know, the situation... And he stopped our tree trimmers that were trimming these trees because he felt, in his opinion,
sure,
you're trimming too much.
Right, right, so, right. But one tree, even 50 feet away, can do some damage.
So and that's exactly what we have. And so when you leave here and go not even a half a mile
right
up and around the corner,
mm-hmm,
you'll see another tree that came across the road. So now you have another double whammy. It took lines down, but it's also impeding the traffic.
And in this area, with the couple of trees that fell, how many people lost power as a result of this?
Like I said, this particular case here is about 16,000, I would guess.
God.
So you can see this Fountain Green substation.
Yeah.
This is right now, we're sitting right here.
Mm-hmm.
So there's switches right here, and these switches are open and tagged, and these switches up here are open and tagged to make this safe so that we can work.
Mm-hmm.
But these lines go up to 543, and they feed a Fountain Green substation.
Doug, how long will it take to get this job done?
With the crews that I have, there's just two bucket trucks,
yeah,
and some of these men aren't linemen. Their company utilizes what they call groundmen, gentlemen that drive
sure
a truck and give you what you need up in the air.
Sure.
So this is, you know, judging the little bit I've been around them, it's probably going to take them, and they're working gosh darn hard, but probably tomorrow sometime.